Hi everyone, my name is Marie Cruz and I'm a Senior Developer Advocate at Grafana Labs. I'm back with another beginner-friendly video tutorial and this time I'm gonna talk all about candlesticks visualization. By the end of this tutorial, you should know when to use a candlestick and what data it needs so you can visualize it correctly in Grafana. So let's say you want to start investing and you're interested in monitoring how the price of a stock or any financial asset has changed over time. A candlestick chart allows you to visualize these price movements easily at a glance. Each candlestick represents a period of time, such as days, hours, or minutes. The candlestick's rectangle part represents the asset's opening and closing prices during a specific period of time. Candlesticks are often visualized as different colors, so traders can easily know when an asset has appreciated or depreciated. By default, Grafana uses the green and red colors, but these can be easily customized as part of your candlestick configuration. A green candlestick represents when the asset's price has appreciated or went upwards. In this scenario, the opening price, which is the price of the asset at the beginning of the time period, can be seen at the bottom of the candlestick's body. On the other hand, the closing price, which is the asset's price at the end of the time period, can be seen at the top of the candlestick's body. A red candlestick represents when the asset's price has depreciated or went downwards. In this scenario, the opening price is seen at the top of the candlestick's body, while the closing price is seen at the bottom of the candlestick body. You can also see some lines sticking out the candlestick body, which are called wicks or shadows. These lines represent the highest and the lowest prices the asset has reached during the time period. In short, think of a candlestick as a visualization of any price movements. With that investment explanation out of the way, let me show you how you can use the candlestick visualization in Grafana. Okay, so first let's add a new visualization to a dashboard and make sure the Grafana test data source is selected. This data source again comes built in with Grafana and is perfect for Grafana beginners. Then under the scenario, I'm going to pick the CSV file scenario and then choose the OHLC Dogecoin CSV file. Let's change the visualization type from time series to candlesticks. And I'm also going to click zoom to data to get the correct date range. As you can see, we are now getting some data. To zoom into a more specific time period, I can also click the graph directly and drag it to a particular point. Now you should see clearly the different candlesticks. Let's click table view to find out the underlying data for this scenario. As you can see, there is a time, open, high, low, closing prices, and other relevant information about the asset. As a minimum requirement, your data must have a timestamp, the opening, closing, and the highest and the lowest prices to be visualized correctly as a candlestick. If you have any issues, make sure that the timestamp is of type time. And also, if you have different column names for the opening, closing, highest, and lowest prices, you can map them by going to the candlestick options and mapping the columns manually using the open, high, low, and close fields. Returning to the chart, notice that if I hover my mouse over the bottom of the red candlestick, the closing price is focus or set bold. The opening price is focus if I hover my mouse over the top. And likewise, if I hover my mouse over the upper wicks or shadows, the highest price is focus, while the lowest price is focus if I hover my mouse over the lower wick or shadows. The opposite observation can be made if it was a green candlestick. Okay, now let's customize our candlestick a bit more. Since our data also contains the volume, which can represent the number or volume of trades done, our visualization also displays the volume count. If you want to exclude this and just focus on viewing the actual candlesticks, you can click candles mode. To display both the candlesticks and the volume count, select both. You can also change the color scheme however you want, but I'm going to stick with the default here. Now, since this data also contains other relevant information information about the asset, you can ignore or include the other data. If included, the data will be plotted as a time series visualization. I'll keep most of the other options here as the default, but in any case, if you want to customize the time series options, my wonderful colleague Leandro Melendez has created an informative video tutorial on configuring a time series visualization, which you can find in the video description below. Finally, let's update the panel title to Dogecoin prices and go ahead and save the changes. And there you have it. In this beginner-friendly video tutorial, I've explained what candlesticks are and how you can configure a candlestick visualization in Grafana. Check out our documentation if you want to know more about Candlestick and all the different configurations, which you can always find in the video description below. I hope you found this video useful, and if you do, let us know in the comments. And as always, happy visualizing!